In your dissent in Garza versus Hargan, you wrote that the court had created, quote, a new right for unlawful immigrant minors in the United States government detention to obtain immediate abortion on demand, thereby barring any government efforts to expeditiously transfer the minors to their immigration sponsors before they make that momentous life decision. You argued that permitting the government additional time to find a sponsor for a young woman in the case did not impose an undue burden, even though the government's conduct in the case had already forced her to delay her decision on an abortion by several weeks. We are talking about a young woman characterized as Jane Doe, who discovered that she was pregnant after crossing the border into the United States. She made a personal decision that she was not ready to be a parent and did not want to continue her pregnancy. She went through every step necessary to comply with Texas state law, as well as steps forced on her by the federal government. She visited a religious anti-abortion crisis pregnancy center. She underwent an ultrasound for no medical purpose, and she went before a judge and obtained a judicial bypass of the state's parental consent requirements. In other words, this young woman complied with every legal requirement, including Texas state requirements, placed in front of her so she could move forward with her decision, a decision affecting her body and her life. Do you believe that this was an abortion on demand?
Senator, the Garza case involved first and foremost a minor. It's important to emphasize it was a minor.
Yes.
So if she had been, and she's in an immigration facility in the United States, she's from another country, she does not speak English, and she's by herself. If she had been an adult, she would have a right to obtain the abortion immediately. As a minor, the government argued that it was proper or appropriate to transfer her quickly first to an immigration sponsor. Who is an immigration sponsor, you ask? It is a family member or friend who she would not be forced to talk to, but she could consult with if she wanted about the decision facing her. So we had to analyze this first as a minor, and then for me, the first question always, what's the precedent? The precedent on point from the Supreme Court is there is no case on exact point, so you do what you do in all cases. You reason by analogy from the closest thing on point. What's the closest body of law on point? The parental consent decisions of the Supreme Court, where they've repeatedly upheld parental consent laws over the objection of dissenters who thought that's going to delay the procedure too long, up to several weeks. And I'm getting to the point.
Before you get to the point, you've just bypassed something. You just bypassed the judicial bypass, which she received from the state of Texas when it came to parental consent. That's already happened here.
But you're still stopping her. I'm not. The government is arguing that placing her with an immigration sponsor would allow her, if she wished, to consult with someone about the decision. That is not the purpose of the state bypass procedure. So I just want to be very clear about that.
But, Judge, the clock is ticking.
It is.
The clock is ticking. 20-week clock is ticking. She made the decision early in the pregnancy, and all that I've described to you and the judicial decisions, the clock is ticking. And you are suggesting that she should have waited to have a sponsor appointed who she may or may not have consulted in making this decision.
Again, I'm a judge. I'm not making the policy decision. My job is to decide whether that policy is consistent with law. What do? I look at precedent. And the most analogous precedent is the parental consent precedent. From Casey has this phrase at page 895, minors benefit from consultation about abortion. It's a quote talking about consultation with parents.
So you are adding a requirement here. Beyond the state of Texas requirements that there be some sponsor chosen who may or may not be consulted for this decision.
So,
and the clock is ticking on her pregnancy.
Couple things there, Senator. You said you are adding. I'm not adding. I'm a judge. The policy is being made by others. I'm deciding whether the policy is then consistent with Supreme Court precedent. There are two things to look at in this context, Senator. First, is the government's goal reasonable in some way? And they say we want the minor to have the opportunity to consult about the abortion. Well, the Supreme Court precedent specifically says that that's an appropriate objective.
Was that a state requirement?
The second question.
Was that a state requirement?
The second question is the delay, your point, and the parental consent cases of the Supreme Court recognize that there could be some delay because of the parental consent procedures. And in fact, Justices Marshall, Brennan, and Blackmun repeatedly dissented in cases because they thought the delay was too long. I quoted all that in my Garza opinion, and I made clear it had to happen very quickly. And I looked at the time of the pregnancy to make sure on safety. I specifically talk about safety. I specifically say the government cannot use this as a ruse to somehow prevent the abortion. I spent a paragraph talking about she was in an undeniably difficult situation. So as I was saying to Senator Graham earlier, I tried to recognize the real-world effects on her. I said, consider the circumstances. She's a 17-year-old by herself in a foreign country, in a facility where she's detained, and she has no one to talk to, and she's pregnant. Now, that is a difficult situation, and I specifically recognized and tried to understand that. And then as a judge, not the policymaker, I tried to understand whether the government's policy was consistent with the Supreme Court's precedents. And I did the best I could. And I said on those parental consent precedents, I said, look, some people disagree with those precedents and think those kinds of statutes should not be allowed. But I had to, precedent's not like a cafeteria where I can take this but not that. I had to take Casey reaffirmed Roe.
I have some other questions, so okay. I ask if you please.
Well, it's an important question, though, and I want to make sure.
It's a critical question.
And I did my level best in an emergency posture. So I had basically 2 days to do this case.
It was a 2-1 en banc decision, which you dissented from, correct?
I did the best to follow precedent, and as I always try to do, to be as careful as I can in following the precedent of the Supreme Court. So.